It's a battle of the malts! I say that because they both start with the word malt. If they both had the word balls in it, battle of the balls. Anywho, we're going to see if the Poundland version of Maltesers are any good. I used to work in a chocolate shop called Hotel Chocolate. I refuse to call it by its pretentious name. And, alright, we're made with 40% milk chocolate, but they just weren't crispy enough. The crispiness is what usually lets down fake Maltesers. Obviously, I have to start with the proper Maltesers, just to remind myself how amazing they are. They are a top-selling sweet at Christmas in the UK. I can't think of anyone who dislikes Maltesers. The bigger the box, the better. And the bigger the box has no indication of how long they'll last. Because once you get started in a box of Maltesers, that's it, isn't it? Oh, the smell alone. I love Maltesers. But it's funny enough, it's not a chocolate that I buy on its own in the small little packets. No. I prefer to get them in a box. And I usually prefer to get them around times like Christmas or occasions. Fantastic. Absolutely amazing. If you don't know what they are, it's milk chocolate with a crispy bit in the middle. Now, I know there's something similar in America, but I used to work with somebody who was from America, and she says she hated whatever there was, but she absolutely adored these. When she went back to America, I bet she gets these ordered in from Amazon. Now it's a turn of Poundland's version. This box from Pound Shop cost £2. These are £1. So if you spend £2 getting two boxes of these, you would actually get more grammage for your money. But it's a big step. I'm already in my mind slightly pessimistic that these are not going to be even remotely similar. And it's one of them chocolates where people are not going to stand for in the little plastic bag as well. Bit unnecessary, Poundland. Do I really need that as well? They look a bit smaller as well. And there's also some misshapen ones. Look at that. Don't know what's going on there. So there's a quality issue right there. Why are they in a plastic bag as well? They've already been wrapped. I'm just going to pour them in. The smell of cheaper chocolate. Yeah, they do smell of cheaper chocolate. They don't sound the same in the box. And Stu as well. Don't Maltesers have a plastic tray inside? No, they don't. They got rid of it. So they actually... Look at the size difference. They also look slightly rougher as well. The Maltesers are perfectly round balls, whereas these ones are just ball-ish. Crispier than what I thought they'd be. Good start. The chocolate is sweeter. I'm very impressed with the crunch. The malty inside tastes stronger. They're definitely better than the Hotel Chocolate version. Ooh. Not too bad at all. Not too bad. You see, I was going to put them in a ramekin and do a taste test between the two. But then I thought, well, actually that's daft because I know they're going to feel and everything different. So the ramekin test is out. So I'm not doing that anymore. You would be able to tell the difference between the Poundland version and the Malteser version. Because you can just taste the difference. The Poundland ones are a bit more malt. The malt centre is much stronger. tasting. And the chocolate's a bit sweeter. The inside's practically very similar look. Similar in colour and everything. So in a bland taste test, you would tell the difference. But very good. Would I buy these ones again though? So you know what? Still probably no. Because I've eaten a few of these now. And I'm starting to get that cheap chocolate burn at the back of the throat of cheap chocolate can give. It feels as if these ones are just more satisfying as well. Because these are bigger. And now that I've just gone back to these, even though they've got a good crunch, they're just more delicate at the same time. Bigger but more delicate balls from Maltesers. Smaller but tastier balls from Poundland. Yeah. So maybe if, for whatever reason, you don't like Maltesers, but you do like the malty taste and you want a sweeter chocolate, then maybe the Poundland version for you. Yeah. Not too bad at all. Not too bad. Me personally, I wouldn't buy these ones again. I still love Maltesers. They're the best for me and for millions of other people across the UK. They're just better. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please subscribe, bell, and let me know in the comment section down below. Do you like Maltesers? I flipping love them. Scratch spell me. Bye. Leave happy comments. Everyone's comments get read out on Sunday outside every Sunday. I do read out everyone's comments I've left from my videos of all the previous week. So on Sunday, the previous 7 videos, all the comments will be read out. I always do it. I'm just trying to push more people to watch Sunday outside. And then when it gets premiered, I do the live chat, and we can have a gab, we can have a chat, we can have a natter, we can have a chin wag, we can have a gabbity gab, chew the cud, whilst my video's playing. It's great, I love it. Scrass, bell me, bye.